Well, that's a big word. I know it's only four letters long, but it's a word that people use because they like the sound of it. People use because they like how it looks when they write it on a piece of paper. It looks good on a hat, looks good on a shirt, on a poster, on a jazz festival banner, you know. But it's a lot bigger than most people really realize.
See, the music is almost like a reflection of sort of the human psyche and human interaction and so the music itself, as difficult and challenging as it is, becomes sort of superseded by this additional challenge of sort of dealing with your bandmates, the audience, things like this. So, you know, as you get deeper into it, you start to realize that all these variables they're endless. You know, where people come from, what their influences are. Their own, you know, personal neuroses and how that affects their playing and on any given night.
It's pretty broad, like what is considered jazz, I guess, or not considered jazz or whatever. I mean, it's from very kind of inside kind of music to big bands to like improvised music, avant-garde, I guess, is another way to describe it.
I find that jazz for me is nothing else but to allow, you know, the band to improvise, to change, you know, some things. The sound of our band is around certain things, right? So I find myself then researching that particular sound myself, like going, okay, when I play with a trumpet player and I'm in between Andre and Dylan, what do you do, right? But when I'm with Brad, it's like it's different. Like sometimes I don't even think I'm playing jazz at all with him, or like traditional, or like, as a matter of fact, if I would, like, somebody would probably look at me going like, what are you doing? Definitely for all three of us is definitely a very big influence, right? So it's almost like for me anyway, I can play all I want with my trio and feel my confident level all the way up here. When I play with Brad, it's like there's a different attitude.
My quartet was the first group that I formed under my own leadership, and it was the first group that I sort of put together with the bit of a mandate, not really, but I was writing a lot of tunes and sort of learning my compositional craft and hoping that these guys would be patient enough to play tunes that I wrote. And it turns out that they have been for years, you know.
We've invested a lot in each other, and we always seem to see positive returns.
It's kind of a conversation, you know. It's not... the lines become blurry between like hanging out with your friends, musicians, just before you go and play, and then being on stage playing with them.
Thank you.
I kind of got turned on to Beatles records when I was like 10 years old, and I just remember really loving the sound of the bass. I played piano when I was younger. I played piano for 3 or 4 years, and I took lessons. And got a guitar as well when I was like 11 or something. I got my first guitar before I got my first bass.
When I was a little kid, from as early as preschool age, according to my parents, I was really interested in drumming and rhythms, and I'd set up like, you know, those ice cream buckets that you get, and play with little chopsticks along with records when I was just a little kid. Started taking piano when I was 7 and started playing the trumpet when I was 10. So as far as I know, I've always been a musician.
No, because drum being my first instrument, I played drum till, you know, I was 21, and still then was just for fun. Like, I was playing, you know, not making that much money playing drums anyway. Then I started to play piano. Piano was probably what made me believe that I wanted to become a musician at that point.
I definitely remember as a child always enjoying the drums and the sound they make, and always sort of thinking to myself, this is something that I could do.
My dad is a conductor and plays the saxophone. My grandfather is a conductor and plays the trumpet. He's 86, he still plays his trumpet. My uncle plays the trumpet and the euphonium and is a conductor. All three of them are music teachers. Both of my sisters are really musical. My little sister Jane is probably the most musical of all of us, but she had the good sense not to become a professional musician. She's a teacher.
My mother was very musical. She was as a young woman, she was a fantastic flamenco guitar player. My father was really interested in particularly classical music. The great classics like Beethoven and Bach, mostly orchestral music, not a lot of chamber music. But
initially, I think I wanted to play the trumpet because my grandpa played it, and continues to. And he gave me my first instrument. It's a little turn of the century cornet. It's quite old. It's very beautiful. I played the cornet because it's a lot shorter, and my arms weren't long enough to actually reach all the way out for a full-size trumpet.
Becoming a known as a place for more progressive jazz, a lot of experimentation going, successful experimentation going on, and a sort of a forward-thinking, open-minded approach. So, what that means for the future is perhaps some sort of development of new forms or new ways of dealing with the music.
The fact that now bands can record albums for a whole lot less money than they could 20 years ago, like the cost of putting out an LP and recording it in the studio and doing all this stuff prevented a lot of great music from being properly documented. But now it's great because like a club here, like the Cellar, has its own label and it's been putting out all these kinds of records by all these bands that probably normally wouldn't have had the chance to record and put out an album and have it distributed, but so there's more and more access to music that way.
Well, jazz seems to be an art form that just refuses to die no matter what. So I would like to think that the future is that, well, in the future it'll still be here. I don't know that necessarily it's gonna like take everything over. I don't think that it's gonna go way underground. I think it's just gonna be maintained by the people that devote their lives to it, and by the people that that give their patronage to it. Like working with my best friends, and the people that I work with are great friends of mine.
These guys are fantastic, very open-minded, very willing to take risks. We get along very well. I mean, I think we understand each other very well.
I think the first thing that happened is friendship, right? And then the fact that you're a good musician or not, at that point, it takes a long time to establish that, right?
But we're all good buddies too. Like that's the thing. Not every band is like that. That's one thing that's kind of special about this band is we love just, you know, hanging out and being friends. And I think it translates into the playing.
Thank you.
I still think I'm a better drummer than piano player, but that I can't prove it. Nobody believes me. Joke.